this month's e-magazine, I've come back to Gold Valley to show you what is a developing trend, not only in the matches, but for the pleasure anglers too. Gold Valley's no different to a lot of commercials. There's a very big head of small fish, small skimmers and small roach that you don't really want to be pestered by. Soft pellet approach can be a nuisance. Now, to get through these small fish and to target the bigger fish, hard pellets is a definite thing that's come to the fore. People are catching not only big weights of carp, but bream, bigger roach and big hybrids also on 6 and 8 mil hard pellets. Today I'm going to use 8 mil and hopefully catch some carp as well as some decent sized silverfish. Basically, it's more selective than soft pellets. Soft pellets is a brilliant way of fishing when the water's cold and the fish are harder to come by. The fish absolutely love expanders. When it's this sort of temperature though, the hard pellets can, like I say, be much more selective and hence result in a bigger weight at the end of the match or your pleasure session. So today, I'm going to take this opportunity to run through with you exactly how I feed and fish hard pellets on the pole. Well, I'm ready to start the session, and the way I'm going to kick it off is about a third of a potful, a 250 mil potful of 8 mil pellets. Like I say, on Bungalow Lake, there's a massive head of small fish, like all the lakes here. And 8 mil pellets shouldn't only catch us some carp, but some decent sized roach, hybrids, and maybe even some bream. The peg I've chosen today is just off of a sunken island, so there might not be so many bream here as they tend to hang out in the deeper parts of the lake. But what I am hoping to do is to catch some carp. Maybe not lots, because I've come out of the wind today because I'm fishing with a pole, and there does seem to be a lot of fish in the ends of the lake where the wind's blowing. I've chosen this peg purely to demonstrate how I feed and fish the hard pellets, and also when fishing a long pole, it's much easier with the wind off of your back. Although the float might be going past the pole tip, it'd still be much easier than holding a long pole in a very strong wind. After I've put the initial feed in of 1/4 of a pot to 1/3 of a pot, I'm then going to loose feed 8 mils consistently all day over the top. Look to create a little bit of an area and look to really attack the swim. 6 or 7 or 8 pellets all the time. A short line on the rig and just lift and drop at any indications. Like I say, this peg has had form through the winter. It's the first time I've fished this area since it's warmed up. And although the wind is taking a few fish away from us, like I say, at about 20 metres there is a sunken island. So hopefully by fishing 16 metres in about 4 foot of water, we should definitely hook some. As you know, with all my fishing, I try to keep it very simple. And the rigs I'm using today are no exception. The floats I'm using are the new Team Darwa 6. They've got a slightly thicker top than most floats, perfect for fishing with 8 mil pellets that are a heavy bait. Also, they're perfect for fishing for decent sized fish. They're not going to fly under at the slightest indication. And like I say, they're my number one choice for fishing like this. Elastic, again fitted in a puller kit, white hydro, set quite pingy. Again, this is not only going to give me a chance of landing those roach, hybrids and bream, but also a very good chance of landing the carp quickly. Coming down the rig that is made up on 018 mainline, a small strung bulk of shot, as with most of my fishing, and then a 20 centimetre hook length of 016 to a size 18 guru hook, which again is a thick wire hook, an eyed hook, tied with a knotless knot and a small band on the hair. This is easy, the pellet can just be banded. Like I say, I can put a 6 or an 8 mil. Today, because it's warm and I think the small fish are going to be a bit of a pain, then definitely 8 mils. The rig is plumbed up, absolutely dead depth. Like I say, all my carp and bream fishing with pellets is done at dead depth. I've got another rig up, this one's 4/16. I've got another rig up, absolutely identical, just with a slightly smaller float of 4x14s. Well, I think that's the rigs and the feeding explained. Now I'm going to feed the peg and hopefully start getting some indications and some bites. Like I say, it might take a little while today, but with the constant feeding, hopefully we'll definitely hook some fish. We've just hooked our first carp. It's taken quite a while, But to be honest, the conditions are against us. As you can see, very difficult to hold your float still. Difficult to feed accurate, but again, the quality fish that we've had, albeit silverfish, just goes to show on those days when the very small silverfish can be a pain, the hard pellet is definitely very selective. And instead of being in and out all the time with small fish, not spending enough time fishing with the hard pellets, you can spend a lot longer actually fishing. Which, when there's odd quality fish around, like here at Gold Valley and most other commercials, it's definitely what you want to be doing. You need to be selective to catch those weights of fish. Feels like a reasonable sized carp. Not massive, but just taking my time. On quite heavy line, 016 hook length. But like I say, just taking my time. I don't think it's the kind of day where they'll be crawling up the rod, so real lightning fast bite this. Almost thought to myself as the float went under, I think that might be a carp. It went under so quickly. Nice mirror carp. And that's a brilliant fish. See there, probably around about 5 or 6 pound. Hook right in the top lip. And there you can see. That's one of the reasons for fishing hard pellets. These warmer days, like I say, when the small fish are a pain, if you can sit and wait and be selective, these kind of fish are definitely going to be your reward. Well, there we go, that was our first carp of the session. And I'm just going to carry on, just pinging pellets as normal. That carp's obviously come to what we've been doing. And I'm just going to carry on pinging 5 or 6 pellets quite consistently. And hopefully, if there's any more carp in the area, we should be rewarded with a few more bites. They definitely seem to come to the noise of these pellets. They get fished for a lot on the pellet waggler, straight lead, and they know the noise of these pellets landing. You can definitely bring them into your peg. I think one of the reasons pellets is such a deadly bait is the noise it makes when you actually feed it, when you throw them in, when you catapult them in. I think the noise they make is really like the dinner bell, and cupping them, I think you're missing out on one of the advantages of actually fishing with pellets. For me, it's about the noise. It's about them hitting the surface. You can't recognise the noise. And it's not only, like I say, the pellets, the smell of the pellets, it's the noise of the pellets that does attract the fish, especially the carp. It's one of the reasons I tend to loose feed a lot more than most people, is because I do like to use everything to my advantage, use the noise of the pellets, not only the smell of the pellets, but definitely the noise. I've seen it here before, walking around the lakes in the evening, you throw a handful of pellets in and it's like the carp just appear from nowhere. A lot of the carp on a lot of commercial fisheries are actually bred on pellets. People throwing them in to the lake or the tank where they're being bred. And they'll recognise this noise and associate it with food. Well, here we are, a bit of a session update. Had 4 or 5 carp now and a few silverfish. And it's gone to plan. Not getting loads of bites, but had some quality fish. I just want to talk about the hair rigging. Obviously, most of the time you don't hair rig on the pole, that's more for waggler or even feeder fishing. But when fishing with hard pellets, you haven't really got a choice. It's the only way to hook them. And just a standard hair rig, the same as you would tie on a waggler or on the feeder, will suffice. Just a 20 centimetre hook length, and just plumb up dead depth the same as you would with any other rig. One thing to mention on a day like today, you can see it's very uncomfortable, difficult conditions. And again, just keep it simple, try and get comfortable, keep warm, don't complicate things too much, because it's very difficult. It's difficult enough in these conditions without overcomplicating it for yourself. As you can see, I'm keeping the pellets going in again all the time, using the noise as well as the actual pellets themselves to attract fish into the swim. Well, here we are, we just had another carp, and what's quite apparent is that the fish have seemed to come in runs of different species. When you get a carp in your peg, there's not a lot else, but a minute ago we had three nice skimmers in three chucks, and then it was followed by a little bit of a quiet spell, and then a carp. And I think that's really been the pattern of the day. I've just kept feeding and feeding and feeding, just lifting and dropping at indications. We've had quite a mixed bag, to be fair, but like I said earlier, they have all been quality. Quite a few indications. I've lost a couple of foul hook carp, but I think more due to the wind than anything else, a lot of the carp are down the other end of the lake. But like I say, we've still managed to put together a decent bag of fish, and we're still getting odd indications now. But like I say, they definitely seem to have come in little runs. There's some roach and an odd skimmer, and then it goes quiet and you almost know that there's a carp. But the conditions with the sidewind and that have made it quite difficult to present the bait and to feed very accurately. But like I say, all in all, I'm pleased with what we've caught so far. Well, there we go, that's the bag of fish we've managed to put together. Seven nice carp. You can see there's a nice big mirror there on top and a nice big common. And over 20 pound skimmers, hybrids and big roach. All quality fish caught on banded hard pellets on the pole. A lot of people don't fish like this, but I think you've seen today on a cold wet day just how selective this is. And when the water's warm like it is today and there's very small fish you're having a go, you want to avoid them and be more selective, definitely try hard pellets. Not only feeding them, but on the hook, on the hair, on the pole. And hopefully you'll be able to avoid the real small fish and be selective and put together a bag of quality fish just like this.